Hey guys, it's Dr. Karl. I promised you a video on the difference between synchronous, non-synchronous, and then we'll talk about subsynchronous. But whenever you're doing a diagnosis of a problem, one of the easiest ways to look on what set or group of failure modes you're looking at is to find out, are these peaks synced with the shaft or are they non-synchronous? So let's give you an example about that. So let's take a look here. You can see, I'm gonna dial this in. Oh, and before I get too much, if you guys are sensitive to flashing lights and have seizures, don't watch this video, turn it off now, okay? All right, as long as you got that medical thing cleared up, last thing I wanna do is get somebody a problem. So, we're gonna dial this in. And so what you should see now is that this is frozen, all right? So the rotor is frozen. Let's look over here at the coupling. So the coupling is frozen, so everything is synced with the one time. And the one time, again, is the frequency or the peak that moves at the speed of the motor driver, whatever is driving this thing. So in this example, this motor is frozen at 1527.94 cycles per minute. So the coupling is synced. The rotor is synced. So we call that the fan, we can call that the impeller, something like that, all right? It's not moving. Now, let's look at the bearings over here.
I can zoom in on that.
See, the bearings are moving, the coupling isn't. The bearings are not synced with the shaft of the motor, so they're not synced with the one time. So that's the situation we have here, is that we don't have a synchronous situation with the bearings. That's why bearings always show up as non-synchronous. So when you're trying to find out, is this related to a gearbox? Is this related to an impeller? Is this related to coupling? Is this related to the foundation or the skid? What you're looking for are synchronous peaks. When you have misalignment and you've got that parallel misalignment and you get those two pulses per shaft rotation, that's the two time. If you've got a three jaw coupling with a Lovejoy and that's misaligned, that will then pulse at three times turning speed. So those are synchronous problems. With bearings, they're non-synchronous. So that's why the bearings are moving on their own, even though everything else is locked in step with the shaft turning speed. So I hope that's a good explanation for you guys. If you have any questions or comments, please go ahead and send me a message. If you like what you see, go ahead and subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.